always think of data science as it's a journey. A journey from determining the right data sources to writing the right machine learning features to pulling them together, the right ones together in the right models, to helping the clients deploy them easily, and to ultimately achieve your objective, which in our case is eliminating identity fraud. What have we done in each of those steps to really make it that much better?
Yeah, so we've brought a lot of automation. We've been very good at figuring out what have really worked for Socure and for the identity problem, and then basically brings lots of machinery, lots of right people to be able to automate. And of course, always thinking as to what do the customer really want, right? Because you can bring in as much of machine learning specialists, as much as data, but if you're not fine-tuning it for the customer, then you're shooting darts.
Give me an example, because the other thing is we benefit that we have so many of the largest banks, almost every major fintech, and if they're not all, if every bank isn't our customer, they're in queue to become our customers.
Yep.
And how much does it help you that every single one of them gives us feedback data and tells us, hey, on these ones you were wrong, Socure, you missed it, your prediction was not right, and here are all the places that you did predict it right. How does that help you get the models better and better?
Sure. So essentially, we've done a couple of things extremely well at Socure. One is figuring out what are the best possible identity data that we can bring in-house, figuring out how to couple that identity raw data with the machine learning while thinking in the eyes of the customer. And so that fine-tuning is what we've done extremely well. Now, how do we further fine-tune? This is where the comment on feedback comes in, which is figuring out what were some of the fraud that we are already predicting. That's not what we really care the most when it comes to research and development. Our research and development teams are focused on what are we missing? What are we missing? And how can we better start classifying those missed type of fraud? And so being able to absorb the feedback, being able to perform lots of additional research on top of the raw data, and then being able to continuously thinking outside the box. What are some of the additional features that our models might not have today? How can we bring in data that is perpendicular to what we already have, so that we can yield a better prediction every time we build a new model?
Cheers, buddy.
Cheers.